Dr. David Kimbrough and Dr. Randall Hughes work to unlock the secrets of the intertidal zone, where the land meets the sea.
There's a lot of living that is made through fishing here. We have a lot of people in the restaurant business in the area that buy fish from these local fishermen. And basically, they all work together, you know, to provide a living for the community. This festival is to help them get through the winter months, you know, when things slow down. It creates a chance for them to make a little extra money.
Professional.
We're having stone crab plates, smoked mullet, and fish dip.
Lynn Brothers Seafood is one of the prominent fish houses in St. Mark's.
83, I think it was, is when the fish house opened. But we had been in business since the 50s. Our fishing industry is very strong.
How does that look?
We wanted to make sure we brought some stone crabs to the Stone Crab Festival. We thought it would be interesting for people to check out. They can generate up to 19,000 pounds of pressure per square inch with their crushing claw to be able to smash the shells of bivalves like oysters to eat the animal inside. This is our traveling exhibit, the Seamobile. We take it to schools all over South Georgia and North Florida and as far as someone wants us to go. And we do programs for children, teaching them about marine life and coming to festivals, teaching the public about marine life and conservation. It's got five touch tanks that house safe-to-handle marine life, such as sponges and sea urchins and conchs and starfish and things like that. The kids can come and pick up different animals as long as they're gentle and they hold them over the water. Horse conchs, those are the largest species of mollusk in the Gulf of Mexico. And then also they're a predator, so they'll actually chase down other conchs and eat them. They'll eat bivalves and things like that. A lot of people don't know how the toxin works on the stingray's barb. That toxin goes to your nerves and sends a signal to your brain. A way that you can alleviate the pain from a stingray sting is by putting warm water over it. You don't want to burn yourself, but it's a really good way to get rid of the pain.
There's a lot more to see at the lab. Jack Rudlow founded the Gulf Specimen Marine Lab. We followed him around as he fed some of the animals.
This is the second white blue crab I've seen in almost 50 years. So that'll tell you something about the rarity.
One blue crab predator is causing a lot of trouble for local fishermen.
We've had a down year this year. Seems to be the octopus to be the problem. We catch 10, 12 a day. They're in the traps, eating crabs.
Blue crabs and stone crabs are caught in the same traps, and both are eaten by octopus. But it's not all eat or be eaten at Gulf Specimen. Animals are also housed at the lab for research purposes.
Something that's really interesting about horseshoe crabs is that they have a chemical in their blood called limulus amebocyte lysate. Well, the reason that it's okay for you to get injected with medicines is because they test them with that chemical. That's the most accurate way of testing injectable medicines. Chemists can't synthetically make that chemical. They have to get it from horseshoe crab blood. So these animals, even though they're not cute and we can't eat them, they're not very good, they have a really important purpose for helping people.
We still have a lot to learn from these animals. That's why the people at Gulf Specimen Marine Lab work to educate the public about marine life.
When you can show them the animals and give them a reason to care and then give them the information, it gives them appreciation for wildlife and for ecosystems. That gives them tools to make good choices in their life, like protecting water, doing things that help protect wildlife. And even if they live in South Georgia and they never visit the beach, they can do things that help protect animals.
In the Grass on the Reef is funded by the National Science Foundation.